JP, we are detaining you in L.A. We're not letting you leave.
Yes, all right.
So we're going to give you some names, and I want you to tell me where they're going, if they're going anywhere at all. Let's start with Madison Bumgarner. Giants have gotten back in the race.
I'll make this quick. Brevity also is my strength. Madison Bumgarner stays put in San Francisco. They're not trading him anywhere. The Giants have played well enough. They're in the race. Bruce Bochy's last year, Dontrelle. Mad Bum stays put. Maybe they move a reliever like a Will Smith or Tony Watson, but right now, the Giants keep their ace.
The team played too well at the right time, and they put a lot of pressure on Farhan. You cannot give away Madison Bumgarner. I don't care what you give back. That's a lot of garlic fries being sold out there on the days he pitches, man. He's the big dog there.
That's going to be really interesting to see if they do it. All right. How about Noah Syndergaard? I'm honestly surprised the Mets are... I don't know why they would want to trade Noah Syndergaard, but please tell me about that.
The Mets, desperate for some good news after the Cano-Diaz trade, did not go especially well. I think, Kevin, for
that
me...
hasn't gone well?
Breaking news. Sources say hasn't gone well okay. So far for the Mets. Syndergaard to the Astros, to me, is the best one, I believe. You look at where he goes, I think they've done a good job of remaking guys in the past, Dontrelle, like Verlander. Mm-hmm. Syndergaard to Texas, meaning Houston.
They get him to Texas, that orange juice money, they're going to have another ring. I tell you what, that those three guys.
He's going to be the three?
He'll win any matchup. He'll go up against any three in the league and win that matchup, especially the way they score. They get him down in H-Town, man. Watch out.
We had Stroman on the list, but you just kind of pretty much told us where he's going to go, so I'm going to flip him. Let's go to, how about Felipe Vasquez, the excellent Pirates closer?
He, I believe, is going to go to the Atlanta Braves, if he goes at all. Now, I think Pittsburgh has said the price is too high, but for me, Dontrelle, the Braves have a prospect-rich farm system. Vasquez is so dominant, and we know, Dontrelle, in the National League playoffs, you got to go through the Dodgers, and that dynamic left arm that you see right there, you think about him matching up against Bellinger and Muncy and Peterson and Seager for years to come. I love Vasquez going to the Braves.
Let me ask you something. You don't think he can come here to L.A.? I mean, that's a big arm to bolster that bullpen. And they need a little help. Joe Kelly has not really panned out like they need him to, especially in those late innings. You think he has a chance to come here?
I think the Dodgers would as well, but their tradition, Dontrelle, has not been to give up the very A-level best prospects they have to get somebody. That's what the price is going to be for Vasquez. I believe the Braves, Alex Anthopoulos, he was a very aggressive GM in Toronto. More to come from him in Atlanta.
He is the king of brevity, J.P. Morosi.
Fire.
Especially. That's one title I've not heard.
I'm working on it, guys. Thanks for helping me.
I love it. I love you. You're the best.
That they wanted Will Smith. Actually, they were very close to getting him from the Giants back in the offseason. Didn't happen. They were talking to the Giants as well. Now, as San Francisco looks like they're probably going to be buyers, probably can't get Smith, but Jake Diekman very much on the Cardinals.
That would make sense. What would make sense for the Cubs, JP?
A bat. Especially, you know, Chris Bryant had a bit of a knee issue yesterday. That they've needed some offense in general, and it's not necessarily the biggest names. Yes, they like Nicholas Castellanos in Detroit, but Eric Sogard, I mentioned earlier, the Danny Santana type of a player who can move around the diamond for you. Sogard is a guy, and you talked yesterday on the show, Dontrelle, with Eric Karros about the Cubs' struggles in the leadoff spot.
Absolutely.
Eric Sogard, better than 800 OPS as a leadoff guy. He'd be perfect for them, and Castellanos as well. We talked before about all the lefties in general. We talked about Felipe Vasquez in that context of the trade market. Well, Castellanos, if you're a club like the Cubs or the Braves, they may have to deal with the Dodgers in the playoffs to deal with all those lefties. You want a big righty bat. Castellanos better than 1,000 OPS against lefties this year.
Well, they're missing Dexter Flower and Zobrist, the guys that are table setters, the guys that can work the count. The Cubs, they hit a lot of home runs, but they swing through a lot of balls as well. They swing through a lot of strikeouts, so that's kind of tough. They need a table setter. I like Kyle Schwarber, but I don't like that experience. I want to put him down in the lineup. That's tough to be a leadoff guy. That's why I don't think we appreciate the Juan Pierres, the Luis Castillos, the guys that can hit with two strikes. You know, it's a tough gig to follow with that. So I think they're good. Not that good, though. I think they're in the middle of the mill. I think their rotation's middle of the mill. I think their offense is. So that's why it's going to be a race in this Central. It's going to be a dogfight. Do they have talent? But yeah, I think so. But I think it's going to be middle of the mill with
them. You said they swing and miss a lot. They actually have the highest swing and miss rate in the month of July. I mean, they are swinging and missing a lot. And it's amazing, right? I know Fowler has not been what the Cardinals had hoped. He's been better this year. They have not replaced him.
No.
They have not replaced him since he left in the... They have not... I know they've had spurts, right? Rizzo leading off. They've done a lot of different things, but they have not had the guy.
So, and some of the moves, the best moves, are no moves at all.
Exactly. You know what I mean? Trust your group from within. And
absolutely.
Of course, speaking of that, Ian Happ just called up today for the first time all year. Still unsure about what his role is going to be, but he gets another chance to redeem himself after being in the minor leagues.
Why not? I mean, it's worth a shot. So let's start with Matthew Boyd. Give us a destination.
Matthew Boyd, I believe, to the Philadelphia Phillies. They had a really good look at him the other day in Detroit. Actually struck out 8 Phillies in a start here this week. Heavily scouted. And, of course, the Phillies were able to scout him in person just by batting against him. I think Boyd, for them, they've struggled to get consistent left-handed pitching there for a long time, Dontrelle. Having that lefty arm there in the NL East, a great fit for them. I think Boyd there, a longer-term play, because they don't have to really worry about winning the division this year. More of a longer-term play, because 3 more years of control after this year.
I love Boyd, especially he's deceptive. The fastball has life, and he has a big whooper-duper breaking ball to keep guys off balance. I think he would be a nice little fit, because they're left and righty dominant in that rotation.
There are not a ton of relievers, and everybody needs relievers. Shane Green is their closer. Where will he go?
I've got him right now going to the Los Angeles Dodgers. We know for the Dodgers, the way that Kenley has pitched deep in the playoffs the last couple of years, the World Series has been Kenley Jansen's roughest round. He's been very good, actually, in general, but you could tell the signs of the fatigue, maybe the high contact rate. So I think Green going to the Dodgers, he would go there probably as a setup guy, Dontrelle, and to show deference to Kenley as the main guy in the ninth inning, but he can close if needed down the stretch.
You said earlier in the show, Nicholas Castellanos is a Cubs is a possibility, need a bat. Is Cubs it, or is there another team for you?
I think Cubs, they're the hottest team on them right now. I do think actually the Phillies would be a fit, depending on how they play the next several days. Or the Braves, given their offensive struggles of late. Austin Riley has really struggled the last month or so after a very hot start. Either the Braves or the Cubs for Castellanos, but I give the edge to the Chicago Cubs.
What do you feel about this? How did JP do? Do you agree?
Well, he's spot on. I don't go against the guru, but I think for me, for Boyd, I like to see him in an Anaheim uniform. I think he's the one that they can control, and then it gives him more length in that rotation. Maybe Minnesota, but that ball flies, and he's already familiar in that division. But I love to see him in Anaheim and them just building it. And really get some guys that can stay healthy, that they can trust, and can get through the lineup twice.
Yeah, that's an interesting call. We will see where these Tigers end up going, but likely they are on out of Detroit.